You're listening to the Four Phase Cycle Podcast with your hosts, Dr. Alex and Megan of Zesty Ginger. If you're looking to naturally balance hormones and learn how to work with your body instead of against it, you've definitely come to the right place. As a duo of an integrative MD and a functional diagnostic nutrition practitioner and best friends, we use the four phases of the female cycle in combination with functional lab work and mindset practices to transform the lives of the women we work with.
We also have a whole lot of fun along the way. If you're new around here, it's best to start with season one before jumping around and plan to roll up your sleeves. Showing up for ourselves and enjoying our lives is what good health is all about. Just a quick reminder though, this information is not intended to diagnose, manage, or treat disease. Always consult with your doctor before making changes. Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to the Four Phase Cycle Podcast. This is Megan, and I have Kathy with me today, the fabulous Kathy. Hi, Kathy.
Hi.
So luckily, Kathy found us on TikTok, actually, the TikTok scroll during quarantine.
Yeah.
And she has become such a bright light in our community and just a staple in all the Zesty Ginger programs. So we're so happy to have you here, Kathy, to share about your journey.
Oh, I'm so excited to be here. Thank you, Megan.
So Kathy is the person we notice. I noticed her right away. She cheers everybody on in the groups and can help people see, really can help people see things that they cannot. And she found us for her own health, right? To grow and to improve health, but now is really taking those learnings and that energy and is helping other women so that they can move through similar challenges and midlife challenges specifically, which I can't wait to talk about today, and really guiding women, as Kathy says, like towards their soul alignment, which we love. So Kathy offers just this safe space, a calm space, a place where you can start on your quest and figure out what it is that's holding you back and figure out where you want to go. So she is now a thought coach and helps women, you know, women just like her and women like us. So that is the biggest goal for us in women working on their health, is that not only will they feel better and maybe be less grumpy with their family or their kids, but then take that energy and go do something awesome in the world. Go help another family, go help another group of people, right? Create something that's good for the environment. So we love, love, love watching this transition. And Kathy, I just want to have you start us back at the beginning of your journey. What was going on when you were scrolling TikTok and you found us and found the Healthy Hormones group?
Sure. Well, first I want to say what you just said was something that when I first signed on to the programs resonated with me. And I was sort of taken back, but I can't remember if it was you or Dr. Alex said, we really want like you guys to do it on your own. And you're giving us a platform to grow from. You don't want people to have to need Zesty Ginger to be healthy, and to give people, women, the tools to be healthy is amazing. And so that was one of the little promises that Zesty Ginger made that came true for me, was that it was such a platform. But I found Zesty Ginger through Dr. Alex's TikToks, and the way she is on TikTok is so down to earth and relatable, and really brought hormone health and women's health at a point that I can digest it. It wasn't, she wasn't in her lab coat saying words that I had to look up. She had like a stuffed animal brain explaining things to me. So it was awesome. But I, what dragged me in was the word hormone, because after the birth of my second child, up until the birth of my second child, my periods were like textbook, what you would think was perfect, 28 days, no cramps, nothing. And then that's it. But after my second child, I had a C-section, and then my periods were just heavy and clotty. And I'm sure most of the women listening know what I'm talking about. And so it just was horrible. And my OBGYN just said, this is just it. This is just what happens, you know? And I was like, this can't be it. And I remember I was volunteering at my kid's school in the library. And this is how bad it was. It's a 2-hour slot. And about an hour into it, I was like, oh my God. And I literally like the menstruation came through my pants. I had to like walk out of the elementary school. It was mortifying. And I sat in the car and I cried and I said, this is like debilitating. I can't go anywhere for this time frame. And so it just had me in tears and went back to the OBGYN. And she said, well, the only thing we can do for you would be put you on birth control 24/7 all year round. And then in about 5 years, take you off. So I didn't know any better. And I was so desperate. And so that's what I did. And after 5 years went by, she said, now get off and see what happens. And so I did. And it was the same, horrible, if not worse. And she said, well, we'll put you back on the pill again. And then in another 4 years, we'll take a look. And so this is almost 10 years that I was doing this to my body to try and just regulate my hormones. So when I got off, I was probably 40. And she said, I want you to stop. And I begged for a few more years because it, like I said, it was debilitating. And then finally she was like, you need to get off. And so I did. And the periods came back. And she said, well, your only option now is to ablate your uterus and either with cold or hot. I said, that can't, like there, this isn't, you know, it's just a Band-Aid after Band-Aid. And I remember it was January of 2019 was when I stopped. And it was probably March or April. And I had never been on social media. And my kids showed me TikTok and I fell in love with all the laughter and the joy that it really brings. And then I just kept seeing Alex teaching me about hormone health. So I said, I have to do this. I have to see what I can do. And I have to stop listening to conventional medicine. And that first call we were on, you, Megan, made it a point to tell us that this isn't a pill for an ill. We're not going to just put a Band-Aid. We are going to give you the tools to help yourself and find out why with the Dutch and the neurogistic testing, what you can do, and then take a look at your stress and how that's affecting you. And so I was all in. As soon as I heard that there was something out there that could help me and help my hormones, I was all in.
Did you have any objections? I know at this point right now that this goes live, our healthy hormones, our last round ever is going to be is open right now to join. So I know there's people thinking like, well, this won't work for me or whatever it is. Did you have any objections?
I did. And what happened was that when I was first introduced to Zesty Ginger, the healthy hormones group, because it was twice a year, I believe you guys did that. And the first session of the year, I could have signed up for. But I have to say, monetarily, I was a little nervous to spend that much. And so what I did was the healthy hormones blueprint, which I think you just did with your viewers, and that I think you said they can still watch it. And so that was what I did. And it was a lower monetary investment. And it taught me so much about my health and seed cycling, tangible things that I could do to make my month and my phases better. And so I started with that and I started doing the teas and I started looking at my sleep patterns and stress and taking all the little tidbits that are in there and really I mean, you guys stuff every program you have full of awesome things. And the best part of it is you take what you need, but then you can always go back. You have access to that information, and that's invaluable. I just realized
you're talking about Zestier, the program, right? You're talking about the one that you purchased. So the Healthy Hormones Blueprint is a free training that we just did, and that's out now. I think you're talking about the actual program, which was Zestier. So anyway, you kind of moved through like the free training we had.
Yes.
And you moved into the one where you were focusing more on your cycle, and yeah, then that got you, because otherwise that would have been a really big jump from like birth control, conventional medicine, never been on social media to like Megan and Dr. Alex and all their woo.
Yeah, no. And it really, and I apologize because I actually, I love everything you guys have to offer, because each program is so valuable and so different, and they just springboard off of each other. So yeah, I did do all that. But the Healthy Hormones group, and I can't stress enough that if this is the last one you'll be doing in this format, that it really is, it's an amazing service that women can do for themselves, is to take part in that. And I started last September, and having done the free training in Zestier, if you remember, I said my hesitation the first round of Healthy Hormones was financial, but I was so impressed, and I had amazing results just from those two smaller programs, that not only did I sign up for the Healthy Hormones, but I did the VIP package, where I was able to get one-on-ones with you, a little more understanding from Dr. Alex with my tests. And so it really, I just knew the price tag, I was actually getting a deal. I knew that I would be getting a deal. So I went for it. Yeah.
What surprised you most about Healthy Hormones? Was there part of it you were not expecting?
Oh, definitely. There was a lot. I think that for me, the two programs before were a little more self-run, and the Healthy Hormones, what surprised me was the community that you guys provided for us and encouraged for us. And speaking of that community, what surprises me is I still am in contact a year later with three women from that program, and just valuable friendships connecting with like-minded women. It's amazing. The other thing that surprised me was the freebies, if you will. Like, I knew what I was buying, but the extra different guest speakers and programs that you added into it was just so giving and so exciting. And I knew that you guys wanted to share what you found valuable and what you enjoyed and what's impacted your life with us, the women in your program. And you don't find selfless people a lot. And you guys just kind of gave and gave and gave, which was amazing. I was also surprised at the amount of, I guess I could call it like mindfulness and mindset work that we did, that really catapulted me into a better healing space.
Were there any strong beliefs that you came up against? So as you know, and anyone who's been through the Healthy Hormones group, we do a good amount of belief work and just understanding why maybe something we're holding on to or believing, or some secondary gain is just keeping us in a certain health place. Did you uncover something that you didn't know was there?
Yeah. I uncovered a lot. I uncovered the reasons why I was holding on to weight. And I thought I was holding on to weight because I couldn't lose weight. There must have been something wrong with my body. But through the mindset and working on beliefs, I discovered that I was actually afraid to lose weight. And, the reasons why are probably a whole nother podcast that we can go into at another time. But to find out that I had more control over my emotions around weight loss was huge. And discovering through that, through releasing that belief that there was just something wrong with me, I'm destined to be overweight, through releasing that belief, I have gained so much confidence and understanding about how my brain works and the defense mechanisms that I put up.
Do you think that confidence is what led you to now really want to help other women and start your business?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. Because not only, so I'm 47, so, and I am in perimenopause, but because of the physical instructions that I was given through Healthy Hormones, those periods are so light and normal and gentle when they do come. Granted, like I said, I'm in perimenopause. So there, I think I've had three this last year, but they're nothing like they were. And it's through the actual strategies that are taught. And then the work that I did on myself through the program, working with other women, because we did accountability partners, and it turned out that I love working with people. And so all of a sudden I created this group of five women that we were accountability partners, and we still keep in touch and chat, and just to be able to help each other and to know that you're not alone. And that gave me the confidence to say to people who were not in the program, there is a better way, and that you actually have all the answers inside of you. And when you take the time to get still and be mindful through the practices that were taught to me from Zesty Ginger, you're able to access that yourself. And so it's really, when I work with women now, I'm not, it's more of a guide, because I give them strategies, but I don't give them anything that isn't already inside of them. And that's something that I learned from you guys.
Very, very cool.
Hmm.
I would love to just hear a little more about the shifts you saw, Kathy. So
yeah,
the periods were not as heavy. And also, if you could just share the things that shifted for you, but also talk a little bit about the timeline, if you remember, only because I think that some people will do something for 1 week or 1 month and then say it didn't work for me. So can you talk about kind of just how that unfolded for you?
Definitely. The first week I was like gung-ho and ready, and we did a lot of what are you doing now? What are you doing now for your health? What are you doing now for sleep? What are you doing now for stress management? And so, then we take a look at what you're eating and how you're eating. And so when you are trying to change something, it can often feel very overwhelming. And so there came a point where I want to say it was about week four. And I honestly like gave up a little bit. And I was like, this is like, I can't, like, I think, talk about beliefs. I think Dr. Alex, at that point, we were talking about natural movement and saunas and doing the detoxifications. And I'll never forget, Dr. Alex said, oh, so if you don't have a sauna, you can draw a really hot bath and put some ginger in it. And I was like, I am out of here. I was like, what? And so, and it just, you know what? But there are women in my cohort that did it and loved it, you know? And so that's what I mean. Like, I'm not ruling it out forever. Maybe someday I'll try that. But it was kind of like, all right, where is this going? I'm not going to, you know, steep myself in a bath of ginger tea. So, like I said, I kind of withdrew and gave up. And it's because I had this mentality of it's not happening fast enough. I thought it was like, you know, by week three, I'd be all set and this is easy street. But I think that you and I had a talk because I did purchase the upper level. So I was able to have some one-on-ones with you, and I was honest and you were honest with me. And so what I did is I remember after that phone call, I sat down and I reviewed weeks 1 through 4. And one of the things that we did in one of the first weeks was the Wheel of Life, where you kind of chart out how you're doing in different areas of your life, health, spirituality, family, love, wealth, everything, learning, education rather. And so I printed off a clear wheel and I did it again. And then I had this tangible visual of the shifts that I had made in my health, in my spirituality, in my relationships. And I actually got to see what I still needed to work on. And so it was just this little reminder of really how far I had come. And that's just, you know, one of the, for the timelines. And I think you had asked me about different ways that healthy hormones has impacted my life. And so to speak to that, it not only like me, the individual, Kathy, has truly, truly transformed. It's been an amazing experience. It has been the most, I can't even explain it, the most amazing experience, worth every minute and every penny that I've spent on it. And I would do it all over again. But I have 4 boys and my husband, and the changes that they've gone through. My husband now doesn't have any artificial sugar. Doesn't have any artificial sugar in anything. He used to be like totally in his coffee or whenever it was just fake sugar. And now he loves coconut sugar. And I joke with everybody because my kids, I make the seed cycling protein balls. And my 4 boys love them. And they're like, oh, I like phase 3 better than phase 4. So, and it's just introducing new ways of eating to my family, you know, to say, oh, here is this flaxseed protein ball, or here is, you know, a smoothie that's made with orange juice and coconut milk, and they'll try it. And it just, it expands through my whole family. And it really is. It's been a godsend for me. I can't even tell you. I actually was very disappointed to see that it was changing. And I know it'll be better. And I know you guys are on to bigger and better things, but it's sort of like, oh my God, what it did for me, I want that for other people. I want other people to experience a change, a shift to renew themselves. And you know what? I know I'm rambling here, but the other thing that was amazing to me was, so the name hormones, I automatically thought that I automatically thought I was going to be the oldest woman there because I just thought hormones was like an old lady problem. And so I was so surprised at the range and the demographics in the group. There were women in their early 20s that, you know, had things that they wanted to deal with. There were women who were trying to get pregnant. There were women who were in menopause. The range of it, and to have that community of women to be supportive with each other, it was amazing. To have people with younger kids reach out to the women with older kids and ask questions and just, it's amazing. It really is. The work you guys do is above and beyond.
Thank you, Kathy. You brought up two amazing points I want to speak to a little bit. So the week four, like that you came up to this resistance on week four. I don't remember if we say it in Healthy Hormones or not, and maybe that's added to our new program, but this is such a common time frame. So I just want anybody listening, no matter what program you're doing or new plan or protocol, there is just this, you get to a point, it's no longer new and exciting and fun, and it becomes an everyday thing. And you're like, where the heck are the results? So that week four thing is, it's a real thing. The cool part is when you get through that resistance, then you're up leveling, you're opening to a new level, because you're like, oh, it got a little bit uncomfortable, a little bit harder, and I kept going. So I'm just really glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
The next part, I would love for you to share a little bit more, because I know a lot of women have this whole, how do I get my family on board? So what was your, I don't want to say strategy, but what happened in your house that you did get your partner, or not got your, that your partner did shift some things and your kids were eating the protein balls? What,
yeah.
Were you just doing it yourself and they saw it? How did this work in your house?
So the kids, definitely. If something is made and it looks good, they're going to want to eat it. So those protein balls and the smoothies and, you know, all the different food tips, they just loved because someone was cooking for them. And if anyone has teenage kids, then you know. But for them, so I said, don't eat them all. Those are my phase three balls. You know, they're like, what are you talking? So when I, for the teenage boys to still want them, they were that good. You know what I mean? And to still want the smoothies. My son Gabe still has chlorophyll every day. Like, it's just amazing, those things. But for my husband, that so many changes have been made, just even not only with the sugar, but even the way we speak to each other from the mindfulness part of this program. But prior to Healthy Hormones, I never ate fake sugar or, you know, the aspartame or whatever it is. It just really always upset in my body. And I knew that, but he did. And I only had the tools to say, it's just unhealthy, don't do it. But through Healthy Hormones, I was able to show him where I was coming from, explain to him different things that I was taught. And when he started to see physical changes in me, both with my body and then mental changes that come across physical, when you're not as stressed, you're going to smile more. When you're not as stressed, you're not going to snap. So when he started seeing these changes in me, he would say, okay, well, what, you know, what are you guys doing this week, or what's going on? You know? And so he just wanted to learn. And in his mind, through diet culture, sugar was bad. Not fake sugar. Sugar was bad. But then when I was able to introduce him to, well, this is coconut sugar and, you know, different things. I never knew there was a coconut sugar. That was just a little thing, one little thing that I was taught in the program. So it's gaining the knowledge through the program. And then I really didn't have a strategy. It was more so that I was just excited and someone to share it with. And he saw that, like I said, I dropped 20 pounds through the program and I wasn't even trying. Like, and that's another thing. I remember when we first talked, our first conversation, and we were talking about different things, what I wanted to change. And I said, I'm like so sick of dieting and I'm so sick of calorie counting. And I'm so sick of the government telling me what my BMI is. Like, this is what you should be for your height. And like, oh, and I said, I just wish I could take every single diet app off my phone. I don't want to track anything. And you said, well, why can't you? And I had fear. I was like, well, then what's going to happen if I don't monitor all this? And that was one of the big changes that my husband saw, was that I was losing weight, but I wasn't obsessed with losing weight. I was losing weight through applying the strategies I was learning.
And you took those apps off, I remember.
Oh, yeah.
The apps off. And then do you feel that there was just like a physical shift in stress that helped lead to just your body going, okay, now we know what to do?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. It's sort of like what you were referring to at that point where you come up against resistance and uncomfortability. Like to delete them off, I felt resistance and I was kind of scared, to be honest. And I was, well, what now am I going to do? And what I learned was, well, I got over that hump and what I'm going to do now is work with my body and listen to my intuition. And, you know, I just remember being taught with, the amount of water to be drinking during the day and how I was taught that most women don't have enough protein. You know, women in our culture are so wanting to cut out carbohydrates, but we need them. And there's a difference between a donut and a sweet potato, you know what I mean? And those things are obvious, sort of, right? If I was to say, what do you think's better for you, a donut or a sweet potato? It's sort of obvious. But then once you realize what your body needs and why, it becomes information to help make better choices.
Oh, I love, thank you for sharing that. It's such a good shift to see. And that excites us, is when we start to get into this place where we realize, oh, I can actually do less, right? Like, yeah. Less counting, less worrying, less measuring, less dieting,
yeah,
and get better results. And that excites me a lot in all categories, but especially starting with health. So thank you for sharing that.
Oh, of course. It excites me too, because I'm not obsessed with those societal markers anymore. And I'm so happy.
Awesome. Okay. Mm-hmm. So now I know this has led into you working to help women in midlife and yeah. Go through a lot of shifts that you went through.
Yeah.
So what do you think is, let's say, the biggest pitfall at this time, or what do you wish women knew during this transition?
Yeah. What I see a lot of, and really where I was, is I think the biggest mistake that middle-aged women make, and I need to clarify, first of all, that like middle-aged doesn't, it's such an antiquated term, and it really isn't like 50. It's, you know, it could have, middle-age is really at any point, because it's more of a entering into a more physical and psychological stage of your life. So it really is just a term, middle-aged women. But what I think I see most, and what I know I felt, was that getting older sucks, and it feels very lonely, and you just feel lost in life. You're not sure what's next, but you know something's over. And I totally get it, because I felt that way. I really, really felt that way. And we're told through society and the TV and social media everywhere, we're told that we need to make external changes to find peace internally. And so you hear these things like, oh, you're not feeling like you're enough? Try this cream, or try Botox, or try fillers. And there's nothing wrong with that. But if you're doing it to feel better emotionally and not just physically, you know, don't let your hair go gray. Don't watch out for that menopausal middle, because no matter what, you're going to gain weight when you hit menopause. All these fear tactics, you know, well, you don't want to look too old, don't buy that shirt, all these things. And it's so easy to believe that fixing the outside will help us on the inside. It's so easy. It's the easy thing to believe. But like, does every woman between the ages of 35 and 55, let's just say, respond to this life change by hiding away or externally addressing those feelings of being lonely and lost? There aren't women that do that. There's women that feel that shift, you know, so like your your favorite mentor, Byron Katie. I think she was 44, you told me, I believe, when she first started her turnaround program. And even Brene Brown didn't get on to Oprah until she was in her 40s. And, you know, you have all these women. I just worked with this woman who was or is 43. And she just went to cosmetology school to become a stylist. It's about reinventing yourself or rediscovering yourself. And so not everybody sits in that, oh, I gotta try the newest workout phase. I have to try the newest cream to help me internally. If you wanna do fillers because you want to look a certain way, great. But if you're doing it to help your internal body, that's the pitfall that is really, it's actually more damaging to yourself and your self-esteem. I mean, falling into that could actually create unease and discontent if you like continue to hold on to that belief. I really love Carl Jung's work, and he says that this part of life, what I'm in, is the second season of life. It's when you are supposed to look inward and you are supposed to get mindful and you're supposed to observe your thoughts and your habits and your thought habits, and you kind of weed out what's no longer serving you, and you take time to make peace and learn from your inner critic. I really don't believe in silencing your inner critic, because if you just listen to her, she's trying to tell you something. And on my website, I have this really fun quiz that I put together for discovering who your inner critic is, you know, which one she is. There's like four different little inner critic girls we could have. So that's, I just feel like if you take, and it's more than a feeling, Megan, I know, and I've done it myself, and I've helped women to do this, and they have it inside of them. If you take that time to make peace and learn from your inner critic, you're going to discover your soul self. And there's nothing more freeing than that. It's, you know, just by adjusting and reframing your thoughts and your beliefs, you will bring harmony into your life. And that's what I teach my clients to do. It's what I do. So it just is, it's exciting to shift from, you know, I spent a good 5 years in discontentment and unhappiness, feeling lost and lonely. And over the past probably 3 years, as I committed to entering this second season of my life, I'm living in harmony and there's joy in my heart. And I'm just living my soul self. And it's what I want for all women. It's so exciting.
Yes, what we want for all women too. Kathy, tell us, tell women where they can find you now and hear about that quiz and start to follow what you're doing. So that,
oh, sure.
Yeah. We'd love to get an idea of like, where do you start? Where do you start with this kind of process for someone who is like, yes, I'm doing all those things. I'm looking to change my external body because I'm aging and I feel different. So any advice and where to find you?
Definitely. So I'll put my website in the show notes, and I'm Thoughtfully Kathy on Instagram and Facebook. And I do have a Facebook group called the Soul Society, which is a free Facebook group. You do have to get on. I don't think it's searchable, but I'm not sure. But anyways, that is listed in the Instagram and the Facebook page as well. And I right now am doing a lot of one-on-one work, but I do have a group program in the works that I'm really excited about, because one of my favorite things from Healthy Hormones was the community that really changed my life and my outlook on my health and my well-being. And that's something that I'd love to foster through the work that I do, is a group program.
Do you think you would be doing these programs if you hadn't stumbled across Dr. Alex's TikTok, or where do you think you'd be without your healthy hormones journey?
had I not discovered this, I can honestly say I probably would have gone in for some sort of physical ablation. I was at a point where it was just miserable. I really don't know. I love to think that the universe has a plan and that I would be so happy where I am now. I love that. But it was being catapulted into my best life, really, going through that program. And I did do the HTA, the Health Transformation Accelerator, and that was huge in helping me to formulate my business and formulate how I wanted to help other people. So I guess to answer your question, really, healthy hormones and the blueprint and ZESTY are you really were stepping stones to where I am. And I'm so thankful. And my family is too, because I'm nicer.
I love it. I'm so glad you brought that up too, that there's this evolution. So healthy hormones is happening right now and open and available right now for our last round. And then in November 1st, we'll start our Health Transformation Accelerator, which is kind of the next level of zooming out a little bit more. We go into the nitty gritty and healthy hormones where we can understand like what exactly is going on.
Yeah.
What are our numbers? Like, what does our lab say? What's on our plate? How do we optimize sleep? And then once we get those, we can essentially know, right? Like you said, we're deleting the apps. We want to implement these things, but then have them not be a source of stress in something we have to focus on for the rest of our life. So get in there, what works, and then zoom out again. And now what do I want to do with that? Where do I want to go with that? What do I want to draw into my life, bring into my life? So health transformation leads a little more to our 7-step process too. We say, bring in anything you want in your life. It can be health goal, but it can also be a business goal or partner goal. Cause this is just a process of how the good old universe operates once you learn the laws.
Yeah. And you know, it really is health transformation, because when you're happy in your business, your career, if you're happy with your family, it leads to better health. So it really is a health transformation. And I know I already have my seat for that course, so I'm not worried.
You're in the family.
Yes, I did. I joined the HTA family. Yeah. And that's been wonderful too, having monthly calls to teach and learn and grow. And again, it's another community. And that I think is what's so amazing, is sometimes through health, through business, through life, we feel alone and we feel like this is just me. I'm just not enough. But to be in a community of women is so powerful. And every person in that community gains something from somebody else. It's been amazing.
Thank you so much, Kathy, for being here today. And I would love everyone to go find Kathy. She's an amazing coach. She's come into our groups now and does group sessions and lessons to teach this strategy of understanding your thoughts and pulling them out. So lots of opportunity to work with her, have her in your group if you facilitate. So thank you so much, Kathy.
Oh, you are so welcome. Thank you, Megan.
Thanks for coming out to hang with us on the podcast. It is our goal to transform the way women are treated in healthcare. And we need your help. We need your help to get the word out. We have a lofty goal of 1 million downloads. And we know that as this podcast grows, we're going to be able to reach more women, get more amazing speakers for you, and bring the most cutting-edge information.
If you found these pod classes helpful, please take a moment to text 5 women you know the link to the series. We appreciate your help so much. Can't wait to see you next time.